So you too, she survived. And because she survived, I couldn't heal. And because I couldn't heal, I'm losing 3 heroes. 2 heroes in fact, just like this. And he has not used Gale Slam here. And there's no way the Lupu is gonna electrify unless he gets stunned here. This fight is over because I'm gonna get Gale Slam. But I get a 4-man stun. I'm leaving. I'm leaving, guys. Hello everybody, once again! This is AikawaKazu. Welcome back to Fight Me Arena Fridays, recorded on Thursday. It's ironic, don't judge, because you need to upload and render and edit the video on Friday. In any case, welcome back to another episode of Math. We're gonna fight 22 beautiful people, I believe 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. Oh my goodness. We are not gonna fight Ryukyuan and Jibragon because we have fought you guys in the past, last time. Sorry Joel and sorry Jibragon. Maybe next time because we have 22 people. I have to actually delete some of my, I don't know, important friends. Someone actually deleted me today. Alright, we were at 100 of 100. Maybe one of the FMF guys actually pulled out. I have no idea, but to let you guys know how FMF works, all you need to do is leave. Oh my god. Is leave in the comments below. Alright, if you're watching this on YouTube, your server, just say that you're from Asia, so we don't waste our time. So your IGN, and as long as you are 2.4k ratings and above, if you have no idea what is 2.4k ratings, because you only like to recognize symbols, alright, let me trash that out for you. 2.4k ratings right here, alright, 2.4k ratings and above, there is no upper limit, so if you are the champion, sure, if you want to waste your time kicking my butt, go ahead. But as you can see, I'm struggling in arena this week because, again, for a month, I have not done anything to improve my arena lineup. Alright, which means today my ass is going to be kicked real hard. To the enjoyment of you, of course, who are watching and those who are watching it live right now. So, who are these 22 beautiful people? Yet last week, we missed out Zeolot. Apologies, we missed out Taka, LF Taka. Even though I mentioned him, but somehow he wasn't in the list or something. We're gonna be fighting just 888, just far. This guy must be super lucky, alright? He has 3 8s inside. For those who do not know, Chinese has a superstition and believe that the number 8 is a very lucky number. So just 888 must be super lucky in this game. We have Misen, also in my friend list. We have Penzram, CH, Cutaway, which is, I believe, someone's alt. I can't remember. I think it's Kaneta's alt, yes. We have Flon or Flonef, Baba, Black Sheep, Amy's, Da or Duika, Dreamif, Brabia, Zilly77, Furex, I think it's Furex, Jin X, X Low X, all the beautiful X's, alright? If you add an X in front of your name, or those with the small and the big one, the XX, you're a winner, alright? We have Grim Coffin, TGBTG, X Kirill, Bane Please, and MX Shadox, which is Mr. Shadow. That's a whole bunch of people, 22 beautiful people, and we are of course going to start from the bottom here. Let's see, what's the lower ratings that we have? What the? Hey, this guy is bullshit. Shadow is not 2.4k ratings, but whatever. Alright, let me just go further down in case we have anybody that is... Alright, I'm not going to go down further. Anything below is heresy, you guys. Heresy. Alright, so we're done. So it seems like the first guy we'll be fighting is actually going to be Shadow, Cupid. Shadow. Shadow. Alright, Shadow. Or Shadox. I believe he has a level 40... Where the hell is Wukong? Yeah, the right guy. How's level 21? I think this is all. Oh, so he abandoned his original account and he decided to use his alt, which has better luck, I think. Let me just double check. I remember his original character has lots of Wukong. Oh wait, it's probably still him. He actually fused away his Wukong, I think. Yeah, but still has two Wukong here. So he actually didn't... Oh, so basically this guy is PvP oriented, guys. He doesn't do adventure. His low level explains that. He has played this game for at least 2 months. The least. And if you're 2 months in and you're level 21, there's something wrong, by the way. I believe 21... When I was 2 months in, I was level 25 or 26 or close to 30 already. So, first guy is Shadow. 34 Ace, 40 Black Rose, 36 J, 40 Yushin, 40 Chiparang. How can this guy be 2.4k rating? This is bullshit, guys. Alright, this is bullshit. Okay? This is bullshit. Oh shit, I used the wrong... Oh, I used the wrong... I used the wrong mastery tab, guys. I didn't change. Oh my god. Alright, seems like I'm... Oh! I'm so sorry. The Jave eaten up by my GIPARANG one-shotted, guys. One-shotted. Jave got one-shotted. I believe that was a level 34 Jave as well. Or was it 36? Can't remember. But Yushin is dead. There goes his level 40 Yushin. Here comes Blossom Slash. And my ace might be dead here, I think. Oh, my ace is dead. It's not over yet, guys. He still has his ace, which means he can still do damage. A level 40 GIPARANG with a quadruple stun. Can't make anything happen here. But his GIPARANG got stunned. Alright. Alright, and my GIPARANG just awoken, guys. Ace is dead. Alright, I think this is in the back. Shadow GG. Let's call it right now. I'm gonna call it, guys. Going to call it. Should be over, guys. Should be over. By the way, Q-Dash, this guy has actually versed me, like, after I added him onto the friend list, he actually did a few, simulation runs, and he has won a couple of them. I do not know how many he has won, but he has won a couple of them. But obviously, I think I have the better RNG here because I was faster. And there's always speed meta, guys. If my GIPARANG can have a possibility to one-shot a Jave at the start, at no cost except one hit on his Void Shield, I'm probably not going to lose because my Jave will not kill himself when he attacks his Jave. And that saves my Jave, and obviously that's GG. Thank you very much, Shadow. Next up, alright, as always, 2.4k ratings, we are supposed to win, guys. And remind me to change my mastery, I can change it on the way up. So, alright, X Gen X above Shadow, 2405 rating, guys. 40 GIPARANG, 32 Ace, 38 Eileen, 30 Teal, and 30 Lupu. Seems like people have them everywhere, oh my goodness. Alright, we Gucci. Actually, do I want to change this? Increase the block rate on this one. The one that I want to change is... this one. Increase damage percent, increase style difference. Increase. Okay, I think this is better. I don't know which one is better, honestly. Any pros out there want to tell me which one is better? When your heroes are all level 40, which one is better, man? I don't know, man. It's not Shadow Cloak, Joel. It's the Shadow we know. The CSGO Shadow. CSGO Shadow, guys. Island is dead once, wakes up, tail counters, Gale Slam is used, good news for us. Still need to watch out for 5-man Celestial Bolt stun from Eileen though. Recently Eileen is crazy, by the way, guys. Eileen is crazy, but Eileen is dead. Alright. Now we need to worry about the 5-man stun from GIPARANG. What's gonna happen, guys? Is it going to happen? We're calling it once here. Haven't called it twice, maybe the thrice we're gonna call it. I don't really know what I'm calling it, but... Talent Strike from Teal. As long as he uses Covert's Eclipse Slash before my GIPARANG dies, I think we are good. Oh, he gets stunned now. Okay, he didn't get stunned. Uh-oh. Hey, the good news is a Teal... Oh, buff removal, boys! 10%! Teal's dead, he gets a 3-man stun, whatever. We still have a Fallen Rose from my Black Rose, but as I'm gonna say just now, before the Teal backflipped and died, is that there's no way a Teal and GIPARANG can kill my Jave. Look, no way in 3 turns. Just look at how tanky my level 40 Jave is. This is why I have not replaced my Jave yet. Yes, I should replace my Chris, but I have not prepared anything to replace my Chris yet aside from my Yushin. My Yushin has no weapons and I'm working on raids. I'm trying to do my 200 rupee challenge, guys, so it's very hard for me to focus on so many things at one time. So unfortunately, my arena will have to take a back seat. As long as I'm above 3k ratings and collecting rubies and topaz, I'm good, guys. I'm good. Alright. GG X Gen X. X Gen X. GG. Alright. Next up, guys. Who is next? Who are we gonna call? Who is calling? I don't know. Alright, who's next? We have 22 people, it's a long list, guys, it's a long list. Oh, okay, looks like we are done with 2.4k ratings, we are going up. We are going up, I have no idea who this is. Alright, we have a few reacts, there we go. I didn't miss anyone below, right? Just to make sure. Yeah, we good, guys. Next up, we have few reacts. Pretty nice name, by the way. 2.7k ratings. 32 Wukong, 34 GIPARANG, 38, 34 Island, 30 Lubu. Let's go. If you're wondering why I'm speaking so fast, it's because we have 22 people to fight, and that means that the episode might be an hour long. The faster I speak, the faster the fight goes. Just kidding, doesn't happen that way, guys. For those who didn't understand a single word that's coming out of my mouth, I didn't understand a word as well, so don't worry. But it seems like I'm faster again, speaking slower this time. And GIPARANG is dead. We should be good, alright? If the Wukong dies soon, we should be good. Alright, Wukong didn't die, but the GIPARANG got Fallen Rose on him, guys. Math is wrong. We need 240 keys if we just do 7-9 exclusively. Kazu sounds like an auction announcer. Look at all the Wukongs! I'm actually gonna lose, guys, rip. Because my ace is dead! Unless a 5-man! No, it was a 4-man kill because the original Wukong died, guys. Alright! This is why having Chris is good. I believe there are some of you out there that believes in the value of Chris, guys. Come on. It's just that my Chris dies way too fast for him to always be killed by Gale Slam. Like, my GIPARANG doesn't die that fast because he has Void Shield, but my Chris will usually die to a Gale Slam. Alright, GG here, Furex. We are done with 3 people. I really wish they allowed me to go back to that same page. But, you know, it's a quality of life update that I shouldn't ask for. It's a heresy to ask for, guys. Alright, next up. Alright, let's see. Like, you know, Netmarble changing it exclusively for FNAF. Ah, Kazu, you're nuts. Alright, X Kirio. 3.1k ratings, guys. Let me just check if I missed anybody here. Nope, don't think so. Alright! X Kirill. Alright, 32 Eileen, 34 Ace, 36 Dalans, 36 Lupu, and 36 GIPARANG, guys. Looks like a tough lineup here. QOL meme. Honestly, it wasn't meant to be personal, alright? Whatever you guys think, it wasn't meant to be personal. I think it's something funny to say. Oh, I'm recording for math, okay? For my viewers. Wasn't meant to be directed at anyone. Touch my heart, I hope to die. Alright, it's a Home Alone reference for those who do not know. And I have not watched Home Alone 1 and 2, you need to watch it. That's an amazing movie. My childhood movie, it's amazing. But it seems like we're gonna get destroyed here with a triple stun from the GIPARANG. Uh-oh. Not good, guys. Not good. We did get the heal a bit here, but my ace didn't die. But you can see my Jave is dead. Ripperonis. And I didn't get my Electrify here. They lose their ace as well. Oh! Okay, it's gonna be close. Because my GIPARANG is not dead yet. Which means even if he Gale Slams now... This is what I mean, guys. This is what I mean. My Chris will die, but my GIPARANG is alive. And when GIPARANG is alive, and Black Rose electrifies, ladies and gentlemen, we should be able to win this. Shoot. It's a big shoot, guys. Because my Black Rose is gonna die here, which means it's a 1 versus 2. Wait, my Black Rose is not dead. Are we gonna see a buff removal? Or am I gonna get a buff removal? Here comes Eye of the Storm. It's gonna do damage to Lupu. Lupu, oh, the Lupu is pretty tanky, guys. I think we're in trouble here. Unless I get a buff removal. Buff removal. We need the buff removal. We need the buff removal. We need the buff. Oh, he's done. Buff removal. Buff removal. Buff removal. Buff removal. Am I actually gonna lose this? No. Are you serious right now? Are you serious right now? Are you serious right now? GIPARANG, last week you had 2 chances. This week, you had 3. Unfortunately, 3 wasn't enough, ladies and gentlemen. 3 wasn't enough. GG, X Kirio. You have destroyed. The GIPARANG battle has happened, guys. But I have lost. My GIPARANG, with his tail behind his buttocks, again. Leaves in shame that he could not get his buff removal as I had to shake to what I just wanted to say. But it's usually XQ real. And next up, we have... Oh, I missed someone. I think it's CH, right? Let's just double check. XQ real. Alright, CH coming up next, guys. 3.1k ratings here. 34, Lupu, 32, 40, Yushin, 32, Ace, 40, GIPARANG. Let's go. Buff removal, so good, Kappa. Nope. This is bad. Okay, the good news is I removed most of the Void Shoes. But the bad news is... it didn't do much, guys. Buff removal is only a myth. Okay, Lupu is dead, that's very good news for me. But the thing is, he still has... Culver's Eclipse Slash. Alright, and I believe Culver's Eclipse Slash is still a 3-turn buff removal, just like Gilsland, which doesn't spell good for me, it's a disaster for me. Good news is we have at least queued the tail once, but unfortunately I got hit by Blossom Slash, so I don't get healed a lot from my Chris passive. Ace is dead, which means no more damage here, but I'm not gonna heal much here. Will my James HP be enough here? That's a big question here right now. With a 752 damage crit from the GIPARANG, that is not good for me. Unless I get a double stun here. Come on, GIPARANG, it's up to you right now. It's up to you. Alright, good Fallen Rose. Increases my chances here. I need Electrify. Nope. Talent Strike first. Oh, it's 2 turns. I'm wrong. Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, was that buff removal? I think so. I think that was buff removal, guys. I think Teal died to a buff removal. So anticlimactic, right, guys? I didn't catch it. I was reading the chat. My GIPARANG must hate me so much right now. I'm sorry, GIPARANG. I mean, honestly, it was 10%. I shouldn't expect too much. Here we go! One more time! One more time! Okay, no. He just died because his time ran out, guys. GGCH. Alright. Let's go. Next up. We'll talk about what you just said later on, QDES, after I finish recording. Because it's quite a lot of things to talk about. But, who is next, guys? I think everyone else is very high ratings here. Most of them, at least. At least I saw Zillord. Alright, Joel. But we're not fighting Joel. We're fighting Zillord. 3.3k ratings, ladies and gentlemen. 40 GIPARANG, 32 Ace, 30 Lupu, 30 Chris, 36 Sun Wukong. Probably gonna lose this one. Hello Afro. You're not trying to get back, guys. So Kazu, nope. Saving my rubies. Bam! One. Infiltrate. We kill the Wukong once! Oh, good news! But he uses Blossom Slash! No! He's gonna kill himself though because of my Jave. You see, guys, I talked about this last week. But now the debuff is there, unfortunately. Dragon Fury is gonna kill the Wukong again, so the Wukong is out of question here, guys. This is what I mean. If a Wukong dies so easily, which it will if I get lucky like myself here, because I have an ace. You can see just now, a Black Rose not in 1-4 formation actually destroyed a Wukong. So, Wukong really need to be tanky for it to be useful, you know? And I might still lose here, by the way, if I get 5 minutes stunned by GIPARANG, but I use Strike of Darkness here. I'm speaking very fast. I'm commentating this fight. I don't understand why people give life steal to GIPARANG though, in terms of a jewel. Doesn't matter if he steals life, correct? Because usually he's gonna die in the first place. Unless you're talking about super high tier, but you're not gonna put HP on him, you're gonna put counter on him, so he's not gonna usually survive anyway. So why life steal, guys? Why life steal on GIPARANG? Can someone enlighten me? Especially when he's gonna die, and then his life steal is not gonna matter so much. It's not like if he has more HP, he's gonna proc his stun better, unless... Okay, I got 3 men stun here. I have Fallen Rose, so that's good news for me. Alright! Should be gone. Now there's just Chris left. Oh! And Chris is dead. Chris is dead, guys. GG Zillord, sorry for missing you out last week. My sincerest apologies, alright? My sincerest apologies. Next up, guys. Where is Taka? Oh, I see him. He's on top. Okay. Next up, I believe we have, oh, now everyone above me already, the weaker. 3.6k ratings, ladies and gentlemen. 40 Yushin, 38 Ace, 40 Jape, 40 Black Rose, and 40 GIPARANG. GIPARANG, guys. Alright, he has a Jave as well. Very, very similar lineup to me, except he changed the Chris for a Yushin. We will now be seeing if a Yushin is better than Chris, ladies and gentlemen. And now with the lightning strike! It's probably better, guys. It's probably better. Unless I got a 5-man stun here somehow, somewhere, somewhere over the GIPARANG. We are gonna get 5-man stun. Can my GIPARANG use his 5-man stun today? Not bad! 4-man, ladies and gentlemen! We're still in the game. Double death, Yushin is gone. GIPARANG is stunned. Fallen Rose, my GIPARANG is dead. Oh, it's not dead yet. Soonish though. Oh, the Fallen Rose. Oh, the comeback, ladies and gentlemen. The comeback. Can it happen here? Infiltrate. The comeback, ladies and gentlemen. The 4-man stun. The somewhere over the GIPARANG. 4-man stun. Did it, boys, in the end! No, I'm not saying that Chris is banned, Yushin, but... But, ladies and gentlemen, you see, Lightning Strike was good then, but my GIPARANG was killed by the Lightning Strike. And because all the cooldowns of my other heroes are put on a cooldown, I could only use Purifying Alias, which means that I had to stun someone. But I got a 4-man stun, so I was lucky over there, alright? I was lucky over there. RNG smiling on me. GG, my friend. GG. GG, guys. GG the Wicker, I believe it was the Wicker, right? Yes, I remember. Next up, guys, we have Grim Coffin with the capital M, alright? Again, with the XX, the small X and the huge X. When you have a capital M, you know, you go for the up and down, the small and the large size letters. Whew! You're a winner, alright? You're a winner. I wonder why he didn't put the N capitals as well. Grim, if you're watching this, you should totally buy a name changer and put a capital N at the back of a name. If you lose, go buy it, alright? If you lose, alright? I actually didn't see what heroes you have, but I believe a level 40 GIPARANG for sure. Alright. Oh, ace! Ace. Ace. Alright, we're gonna get a 5-man stun, ladies and gentlemen. Easy mode. It's a 3-man, I can take that, I can take that. But Lupu is not stunned though. Dark Thunderwolf, alright, my Chris looks dead. Oh, my Chris is dead. The counter, boys. A poke. Oh, Electrify on Yushin. Must be one of those lucky guys with a 30% one. Because that was try number one and he got it. Looks like a 30% one to me, to be honest. The good news is his ace is dead, which means it's not going to do a lot of damage here. But if GIPARANG dies, he has not used Gale Slam, and I have two of my undead heroes already dead. It's not good. I need to kill Lupu somehow. I need a counter somehow. I'm 100% sure it's going to be Gale Slam next skill. Damn. And he has 4 Wukong, guys. GIPARANG is not even undead yet because he has the Wukong around here. Dragon Fury is not going to do enough damage here. Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. We still have a chance here. Unless I get double stunned. Please no, please no, please no, please no. No! It's not good. It's not good, guys! We lost. We lost. We lost. We lost. We lost. We lost! See, guys, when you have a Wukong that can survive until everyone else is dead, we lost. Guys, we lost. Can a miracle happen? No, there's no miracle tonight, guys. There is no miracle. So, Grim Coffin, you can keep your capital M. You can keep the small N as well, alright? We lost. Okay. But you might want to take my suggestion on the capital N at the end. It looks very, very good. The capital M looks great. If a capital N at the back, even better, alright? Even better. Alright, next up, who else? Who else is coming up next, guys? We have Xiao Amis or Emis? Emis? I think it's Xiao Emis. Alright, so 3.7k ratings here. 40 GIPARANG, 40 Black Rose, 34 Ace, 36 Eileen, 32 Lupu. He has a lineup that's supposed to win my lineup, ladies and gentlemen. His ratings is higher as well. So it's gonna be up to the gods of RNGesus to smile upon us right now. and the singing help here. I'm not too sure if I should sing right now. It might be too late, ladies and gentlemen. It might just be too late. Oh, Chris dead. I needed to kill the Lupu, but it didn't happen, guys. Didn't happen. Oh! I didn't did! Somehow, somewhere over the rainbow, guys. His ace kills himself as well. Oh! Blossom Slash. Not good. Not good, guys. Not good. Blossom Slash, not good. Okay. Fallen Rose on GIPARANG. Good. Good. Looks like orange is on outside. As I mentioned, guys, this is how much a 20% accessory can make to your gameplay. Alright. Look at that. Buff removal. Psh, gone. Over, guys. Over. Alright, and now you see this Lupu is just sitting duck. He's dead. Can you imagine the guy that got a 30% electrify accessory? By the way, Liz got it. I didn't get it. I got a plus 20% crit rate. I didn't even put it on my chain because I think I was gonna remove it. But for those who got a 30% CC accessory, it's insane. Alright, as I mentioned last time, without my 20% electrify accessory on my Black Rose, I will not be at the ratings that I am right now. That's how much it carries you, because that's a very high chance your Black Rose is gonna counter Lupu. Now you don't see my Black Rose countering a lot, which is actually not good for my lineup actually, I realized. Because my GIPARANG is countering right now, and my GIPARANG doesn't have electrify accessory. So I do not have my Orange Jesus coming to help for me more than it can in the past. Because last time only my Black Rose will counter, and because she counters more, that means there's high chance for me to electrify my opponent. But now my GIPARANG counters instead, so I do not know which is better, to be honest. So you have the discussion and debate when you have two characters that use counter in your lineup. So this is for the pros to figure out, guys. This is for the pros to figure out. I'm not a pro. Alright, so Amy's GG. Next up, we have TGBTG. It's 3.7k ratings here. Aizen 25 is 15, it's not in the list, just to double check. Nope, not in the list. 32 Lupu, 32 Eileen, 40 Yushin, 30 Ace, and 40 GIPARANG. My god. For Aldiator 91, you need good equipment and good jewels. You can have the heroes, but if you do not have good equipment and good jewels, you will not get to master. You see, this guy is electrified just like that, guys. Just like that. Even though I'm probably gonna lose this game, but you can see Yushin is taken out of the picture here. And because Eileen is 32 here, you can see, guys, how important it is to have Eileen at 32. Because she's 32, she survived. And because she survived, I couldn't heal. And because I couldn't heal, I'm losing 3 heroes. 2 heroes, in fact, just like this. And he has not used Gale Slam here. And there's no way the Lupu is going to electrify unless he gets stunned here. This fight is over because I'm going to get Gale Slam. But I get a 4-man stun. I'm leaving. I'm leaving, guys. I'm leaving. Ooh, I won! I thought we have lost, guys. I thought we lost. I thought we lost, guys. But we came back, we won. Thank you, Shane, for greeting me. Actually, I went to take a piss. Not trying to say that I took a piss over my opponent. I'm just saying that I went to take a piss. Alright, I need to go to the toilet. I drank a lot of water. And I've been talking a lot, so I need to drink some water now. Alright, good game. TGB. TG. Alright, GG, my friend. GG, my friend. Alright, next up, guys. Who's next? Who is next? Who are we calling next? We are calling this guy called Mr. Baba Black Ship. Have you any wool? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. 3 bags full. How do you come to 3.6k ratings with 30 Ace, 30 Island, 30 Leo? How can you win with a dirty Lupu? 4 level 30s and 1 level 38. Let's find out, Kazu's gonna lose. How? 4 level 30, 4 lots. Not 4 lots, 3 level 30, 4 lots, 1 level 30 something. Who was the other level 30? Eileen, what the hell? How? How is this person at 3.7k ratings? Oh, I know why now. The equipment is good, guys. The equipment is good! I take it back! I called myself to lose, alright? I said I was gonna lose, guys. And I was right, alright? I was right, alright? I was right, okay? I said I was gonna lose, okay? Look at this. The worst skills you can cast at the start. Gale Slam right now. Do it for me, Lupu. Please do it for me. Gale Slam, thank you very much. We're gonna lose. I called it, guys. Somehow, it was so deceptive, alright? It was so deceptive. There's no way we're gonna win. There is no way. There is no way. The only thing that can happen right now, even the only hope that I had was gone, because I was saying that Black Rose can electrify 5 guys. Can't even say that properly. Black Rose can electrify 5 guys. No, she cannot. But... You see, guys? You see? Wait. Alligator. Alligator 91. You see what I mean? It's not about having the heroes, alright? It's about having the equipment. Alright? He had good equipment, alright? Let's check him out, alright? I need to check it out. Unbelievable! 4 level 30s! He moved faster than me, by the way. 4 level 30s! Moved faster than me. Baba Blackship. We even sang a song for him, guys. Let's check it out, alright? GIPARANG! Alright, 7 Knight Speed Weapons. Standard, alright? Let's look at Teo. 25%, alright. So he's already faster, Lupu. Crit rate 30%, 25%, okay. Ace 20. What? Okay, my Jave is not using speed weapons. He's using 20% speed. Eh, come on. Come on, man. I have no words. Next up, Bin, please! Oh my god. 32 Till, 34 Eileen, 38 Dalons, 34 Ace, 32 Lupu. Oh, 6-star draw on his tail. All his guys are accessory. Okay, Cupid said it, so we have to show it, guys. We have to show it. Alright, look at this. Alright, let's check out his tail. Oh, look at that. He got a 30% science accessory, which he didn't need to use, by the way. No jewels! Alright, Cupid, no jewels on Teo. Oh, you mean this one, okay. The 6-star accessory. Blind on his Lupu. Ace? Hey, come on, man. This guy has no jewels. How did I lose? Will it be the first ever rematch that Kazu's gonna do? Because it's salty. Nah, I'm not gonna be salty. I'm done, guys. Next up, Bane, please. 32 Teo, 34 Island, 38 Dalons, 34 Ace, 32 Lupu. Let's go. Just got retouched by the RNG gods. No, he's not. He didn't get touched by the RNG gods, by the way. It was very much expected for him to use Gale Slam. His Lupu already used Dimension Slash. And I already told you that the way they program Lupu is such that he will always somehow have priority over the other skills of other classes. I can tell you that out of 10 matches that you play, probably 5 matches will have Lupu using his skill first. Probably. And that's a very high ratio, by the way. It's supposed to be 1 in 5 chance. In fact, not 1 in 5. It's supposed to be... If everybody has 2 skills, assuming... Yeah, it's still 1 in 5 chance, I guess. For him to use any of his skills. And you will see Lupu usually use his skills first. And... I guess it's not good in Master and Above tier, because... In Master and Above tier, the undead heroes don't actually die so fast. So if he uses Gale Slam first, usually it's bad. But you can see right now, he usually uses it in my ratings after my guys are dead. So it's good for him. Yeah. So, GG Bane, please. We got destroyed here. Alright, next up, guys. Next up, we have... Running out of breath already, guys, by the way. After Bane, please, we have... Not download, it's Berbier. Nice name, by the way, Berbier. 38 Ace, 32 Wukong, 40 Island, 32 Lupu, 38 GIPARANG. Now we're just watching us get destroyed, guys. Let's be real, alright? Let's be real. It's because of the lethal stats. Lupu using skills first is not really good, seriously. I know, in the master tier rating it's not good Frisbee, but in my ratings it's usually good. I mean, what can go wrong with a 4-man pierce? Correct? What can go wrong with a 4-man pierce? It's like me casting Dragon Fury on my first turn. It's usually not bad. It's bad because there are a lot of Void Shield units nowadays, but it at least removes people like Yushin, it removes people like Ming Ming, you know, if there is even Ming Ming in the first place. But it basically removes some of the heroes that can be pretty annoying if he uses Dimension Stash first. And you can see, if he uses Dimension Stash first and Gilstam later, in my ratings, usually that means that my undead guys are dead. And you can see right now that's happening, and yeah, this is why this guy has higher ratings than me. Because in my ratings, this is what is going on right now. Kazu invest on Bane since he lost him. Kazu is so done with Bane, I tell you. Yeah, I agree, at your tiers, there's not as many Void Shield frontliners. That's why Lupu can bring you to places, guys. Lupu can bring you to places. Alright, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have, after Mr. Brabier, we have Dream Eve. Alright, 4k ratings, guys. Ace, Black Rose, Chris, Eileen, and GIPARANG. I'm not even going to mention a level because I'm going to assume level 40 here, except for the Eileen there, that was level 36, I believe. Global is so different to Asia Silver. I believe Blaze because we have more players in Asia. I think some of the global players mentioned, I think Mirumu, he mentioned that 3.8k ratings in mine server, which is Asia, I've ranked 20,000. 3.8k ratings in your server is ranked 8,000 or something. Yeah, so it's like 20,000 versus 8,000 or something, or even worse than 8,000. I can't remember whether it was 800 or 8,000. But basically in Asia, we have many, many more players. So that means that our arena is going to be filtered out a lot different as well. Oh, look at the GIPARANG, he runs back. So cool. Oh, the GIPARANG has a 30% accessory, guys, I think. Or was it the 20% one? Oh, buff removal. I can only win this if I get buff removal, guys. Sad truth. Or possibly a 3-man stun, but I might get stunned first. Oh, no buff removal. No buff removal. Oh, GG, Fallen Rose, guys. No more buff removal. RIP, guys. Even though I got a double death on Chris, but yeah, it's over. It is over. Who is the middle? I need to add this guy to kill his dragons. He kills your dragons. You don't kill his. That's the sad truth. Alright, GG Dream Eve. Who is the middle? Alright, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have Qtawei, I think it's Qtawei. Yeah. 34 Ace, 40 Yushin, 40 Ming Ming. Oh, Ming Ming, guys, that's what I'm talking about. So cute with the sailor costume. Rimino is the Chuck Norris of Global. Auto as well. Yushin is dead. Yeah, you can check out this stream, guys. Twitch.tv/Rimino. You can check out his VODs. Blaze plays for days. You know. Oh! Ultimate Dandelion! Hey, it's actually so cute. The duck actually pressed down. I actually have a chance to win this one? Oh! Double stun! Oh! 5 versus 3! Yeah! Oh, look at the Ming Ming, super tanky, but it's gonna die to the death debuff. Alright, I think we got this one, guys. I think we got this one. Oh, it's gonna die to the infiltrate! Ming Ming infiltrated, guys. The enemy Black Rose is like really hit the undeads, only hit them. And even infiltrate them. GG, cutes away, looks like your ult. Did I win you the last time? think so. Kaneta. I think I won Kaneta last time. I can't remember, man. But GG again. Even with your alt account. Maybe I lost the previous one. I can't remember, to be honest. Alright, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have Panzram. 4.1k ratings, 40 Black Rose, 40 A's, 38 Dalans, 38 Lubu, and 40 GIPARANG. Let's go. Oh, the Alice costume. This person going for the HP increase. For those who do not know, right, there's actually something going for HP block or double block in higher tier arena because your HP benefits or your HP is actually halved in a PvP, if I'm not wrong. Can't remember which one. Like, your total HP is halved, or is it the HP that you get from, like, your benefits from the equipment that you get is halved? It's one of those, I think. Or could be both, which means your total HP is just half in PvP. I don't know the actual specifics, but basically wearing double HP is not necessarily effective in arena. HP block might be more effective, even going double block might be more effective if you're a level 40 fully transcended hero. Okay, it's half total according to Dark News. So yeah, there's a your total HP divided by 2, so your HP gear's effectiveness is essentially half. Oh, Mew is like, if I'm not wrong, so he's not sure as well. Oh, the ace didn't die, guys! Uh-oh. Now my Black Rose is gonna die. Oh, look at the damage. 855 damage crits from the GIPARANG, holy shit. Oh, he has buff removal! He has buff removal as well, guys! Okay, we lost this one. GG Panzram. It's gonna take a while for me to die, though. Oh! Nah, it's not gonna happen. Wait! Is this actually gonna happen? Guys? I bet behind the scenes right now people are like, Kazu, can you please give something good to Chris? He could have killed the Lupu! I don't think he would. Okay, my Chris has double equipment, like he has double weapons. Not the best. Alright, his attack could be 320. And if maybe given speed, he could have speed attack just now, but maybe with plus 40 damage, yeah, let's say if it's the damage is 320, if I use a 7-9 weapon, 40, 80, I might have killed him. But I'm changing out my Chris soon, guys, I don't know, man. Anyway, GG Panzram, it was close. Alright, it was close. Next up, Zilly 77, 36 Lupu, 34 Wukong, 40 Black Rose, 32 Ace, and 40 GIPARANG. Let's go. This is literally me last time when I fought Kazu the first time. My Chris had poop weapon. Oh, the ace! Oh, didn't get him the HP threshold though. Feels bad. I'm starting to feel a bit lightheaded because I have not eaten for my dinner and I'm speaking so much. It requires more effort than you think, by the way, guys, to maintain at this energy level for an extended period of time. I believe we have at least been going at it for the last 20 or 30 minutes. This episode is probably going to be 40 or 50 minutes since we're fighting 22 people, even though I'm going about this really, really fast. We get a... Oh man, the Wukong hasn't died yet, guys. This is not good. Oh. Blossom Slash. Okay, Wukong is dead here. Good news is... Oh wait, the Wukong died twice. Oh! Oh yeah, I think I did Dragon Fury or something. With the ace out of the question, we have a chance here, ladies and gentlemen. The question is, can we survive until we kill Lupu? That is the big question, ladies and gentlemen. Because Lupu is not gonna die, and if Lupu doesn't die, my team is dead very, very soon here. I just lost my Black Rose. Dragon Fury will kill the Black Rose. No, he didn't kill the Black Rose. Not enough damage. No crit. No crit on my Jif. His GIPARANG died. Please. Yes, 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 die, die, die! 377! GG! GG, guys. Kazu investing in chances that he will get a better unit than Chris. Maybe, aces, maybe. I'm just saving up rubies right now. Alright, GG, Zilly 77. Seems like the 77 is not lucky enough for you. You might want to change to the 888. We'll find out when we fight against just 888 here, but not quite yet. As the next better player is FloNav. 4.1k ratings, 40 GIPARANG, 36 Ace, 40 Chris, oh my goodness, 40 Chris, 40 Black Rose, and 38 Nerdsa. No way I'm gonna win this. As I mentioned, Nerdsa counters my lineup, guys. And he has a 40 Chris, which means the Chris is not gonna die very easily here. Not good. Not good. Here comes the infiltrate. My Chris is already dead. RIP. Oh, I lost my GIPARANG as well. Fallen Rose at the worst possible time. Nerza, HP threshold. My Black Rose is dead already. Counter. Dragon Fury. My Jade kills himself on Nerza, that's what I mean. Ace not even dead yet, level 36 with not even a HP threshold. I need a 3-man stun here after Chris dies, which is not gonna happen, guys. Chris is not going to die, unfortunately. And we just use Blossom Slash, our only hope. Blossom Slash kills off GIPARANG! We just killed off Chris! Fallen Rose! Oh, this is GG. This is GG, guys. Oh! Yep, it's gone. It's gone, guys. It's gone. Because my Chris is like face farming right now. GG, Flonef. Got destroyed, guys. Got destroyed. Next up, we have Dark Immune? Nah. You're gonna be fighting just 888, guys. Is the 888 gonna give more luck than the 777 or the 77, Zilly 77? Let's find out here. Alright. He's faster. Guandao Hua Wu. Guandao. Why is it called Guandao? Is Guandao the spear he's using? Is Guandao spear? Oh, okay, we got destroyed, guys. Don't even need RNG, guys. Doesn't even need luck, guys. Just 888, don't even need luck, guys. There's only a reason. I mean, there's a reason why people are in Master tier, you know. And yeah. I don't see myself winning here. My GIPARANG got stunned. He's probably dead, he's dead. My Black Rose is gonna counter. Didn't electrify. Can't even kill the Yushin. Yushin's gonna lightning strike here. Nope, Dark Tunnel Wolf, which means Black Rose is dead, I think. Black Rose is dead. Even if we get a 4-man stun here, it's not gonna be good enough, I think. The battle of the buff removal, guys. It's gonna be a 3-man stun. Oh, got a 2-man. But Fallen Rose. Oh, GG blinded, guys. GG blinded. GG blinded, guys. Can't even kill Black Rose. Can't even kill Nerza? His Chris is like, what's up, son? The previous match, guys. GG! Next up, we have, I believe, Misam, then Taka, then X Low X, and then that's all, I think. Alright, Misam. Mess Sam, I think it's not Misam. I think it's Mess Sam. Mess Sam. Messing around, Mess Sam. Messy. Oh, Droopy! As a leader. So pretty. Droopy is so pretty, guys. But Shane for life. Shame for life, guys. Oh, Gale Slam first. Oh. Lady Luck shining on me. Even the Dragon Fury didn't one-shot the... By the way, Ace is not HP threshold. You can see he still have like additional 1%. Hey, look at my Ace. My Ace is at the HP threshold. The Ace is not at HP threshold. Look at that. Survives. How do I win this? I need to counter the Lupu right now. Didn't happen, guys. Didn't counter the Lupu. And he still has Wukong. And my Black Rose is dead. Counter. Psh. Eye of the Storm. The B-Dam is not even dead. And I get electrified. And I get stunned. No, he doesn't get a stun. If he gets stunned, both my characters will stand up. Oh wait, he got the stun. What the? What the? Usually if you see a character get re-debuffed, right? Like you see now, you see Chris standing up, he's gonna get stunned. Yeah, but my GIPARANG someone didn't stand up just now. I don't know why, maybe because of Electrify, I don't know. But GG, Messen. GG, alright. cannot stun Black Rose. That is true. That is true. It's remove a buff, I think. She's immune to debuffs. That is true, Kenneth. I always forget that. GIPARANG too low level. Honestly speaking, this is why I didn't invest in him. For me right now, the lineup that I have, it doesn't really matter if my GIPARANG is 40 or 32. Probably will help me win some matches, but it's not gonna have that impactful difference, you know. Like, if as long as I can maintain a 3.6k ratings, which I probably would still able to this week, I will still not get my GIPARANG to 40, because the only way I'm gonna do that is through Fina's, and I believe 4 Fina's right now. 5 if I finish this month's Fina monthly quest, and yeah, I don't think I'm gonna use my Fina on him. I wanna save it for future heroes, even use it on certain heroes in my dragon team too, I don't know. Just don't feel that I should waste my Fina's on him, because if I'm gonna use my Fina's, I have to use all my Fina's, I can't just use one, you see. Why am I waiting for, guys? Why is it not over yet? Hello? Am I waiting for a glimmer of hope here? Silenced and stunned. Yo 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 yo! Oh, okay. GG. Alright. Who's next? Who's next to trash my face here? Who is next? Oh, wrong place. As I mentioned, I'm feeling a bit lightheaded right now. Next up, we have LF look for Tuo Taka. Not look for Tuo, I guess. It's just LF Tuo Taka, guys. 4.3k ratings here. 30 Teo, 38 Ace, 40 Black Rose, 38 Lupu, and 40 GIPARANG. Not expecting to win this, as I mentioned. As long as there's a Teo and a GIPARANG and a Lupu, my odds of winning are pretty much 5%. And the 5% comes from the multiplication of how you see the odds of how the 20% electrify and 10% you know, buff removal is going to come into play. And of course, including the 20%, not 20%, of course, looking at purifying alias from GIPARANG. Yep, so I have about 5% chance of winning if everything falls into place. It's actually probably lesser if you do the math. I didn't actually do the math. But you get what I mean. There's a small chance. But of course, looks like the small chance is not happening here. I can only look and watch in despair as I get destroyed, guys. Even if I get a 5-man stun here, I wouldn't win because GIPARANG will wake up. And I got 1-man, and look at that. Even if Teo died, he would have woken up as well. That's what I mean. It's very hard for me to win as long as the guy has a Teo. Because if it comes to the Battle of the Undead, Teo usually wins because Teo has Covert's Eclipse Slash, and GIPARANG and Chris both do not have any skill to counter against Covert's Eclipse Slash unless... Okay, no, I thought he killed by buff removal. I was wrong, guys. I was wrong. I'd admit it. But you need like I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. Maybe we get a buff removal, I don't know. Can we see it happen? We see our first counter. Covert Eclipse Slash right now. It's time for my GIPARANG and my Chris to sleep. Oh, my GIPARANG died, guys. Oh, my Chris dies. She didn't even need Covert Eclipse Slash, guys. Blossom Slash was enough. Alright, I believe we have come to our last two fights. Or our last fight, in fact. We have X Low X, 4.4k ratings here. Oh! Oh! 5% chance here, ladies and gentlemen. Another droopy lead. Wow, interesting, guys. Remino, you have some droopy fans here. You should be happy that you are changing the meta of Asia, right? Changing the meta of Asia. More people are actually building Droopy because of you. Good job, Rim. You have infiltrated into the Asia scene. Good job, my friend. Good job. Oh, I lost my Ace though. Gale Slam is being used. That means I have no damage. My Jade is dead. Electrify on Lubu. Alright, my Black Rose is dead. (sighs) There's no way that I'm gonna win this. No way, guys. There's just no way. I'm gonna get silenced here. It's like literally shut the fuck up. Yep. Both of them gonna shut the fuck up, guys. Are we here to watch yo-yos? Oh. 210 damage on the Wukong. Can't watch anymore, guys. Can't watch anymore. Let me rest. I'm feeling lightheaded. Got stunned. Just let me die. X, low X. Just let me die. Alright, Blossom Slash, guys. Where have I seen this before? Undead vs. Wukong. Resident Sleeper. Alright, I think that's it. Let me just check my list. Bam 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 bam. Yup, we have fought everybody. Everybody, everybody. Everybody say FNAF. Just kidding, guys. And that's it for this week's FNAF. My name has been AikawaKazu. Hope you guys enjoyed this week. If you did, as usual, please slam the like button. If you want to watch FNAF live on stream on Thursdays, we stream it at 7:30 PM GMT. Plus 8. Alright, links of course to my stream in the description below. My name has been AikawaKazu. I think I said that twice. Thanks for watching once again. God bless. And as always, thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys and girls in the next one. Take care. Goodbye. Adios. Juju to all the people that left your IGN below. Alright, bye bye.